हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज प्रियंका। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम ऑन ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन बाय द फर्स्ट एंगल प्रोजेक्शन मेथड। सो लेट अस फर्स्ट ऑब्जर्व व्हाट इज द गिवन थ्री डायमेंशनल ऑब्जेक्ट। सो इफ वी ऑब्जर्व दिस ऑब्जेक्ट हियर, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स इज गिवन। सो वी हैव टू कंसिडर द फ्रंट व्यू इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स, बिकॉज इन द फर्स्ट एंगल प्रोजेक्शन मेथड द फ्रंट व्यू इज कंसिडर्ड एज द प्रिंसिपल व्यू। सो इफ वी ऑब्जर्व देयर आर टू साइड्स फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट, राइट हैंड साइड एंड लेफ्ट हैंड साइड। सो नाउ ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड देयर इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स इज गिवन, सो वी विल कंसिडर द फ्रंट व्यू इन द राइट हैंड साइड ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट। सो नाउ वी विल मेजर व्हाट इज द टोटल लेंथ, हाइट एंड विड्थ ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट। सो व्हाट इज द टोटल लेंथ, दैट इज 15 + 15 + 5 + 5, दैट इज इक्वल टू 40 mm। नाउ इफ वी ऑब्जर्व द डायमेंशंस ऑफ द गिवन ऑब्जेक्ट, दोज आर वेरी स्मॉल। सो वी विल यूज हियर द स्केल 1:4, दैट मीन्स 1 mm इन द गिवन ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज इक्वल टू 4 mm इन अवर ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। सो फॉर दिस टोटल लेंथ 40 mm, we will use here 4 times larger scale, that is 40 × 4, 160 mm. So in the orthographic projection we have to consider here as a 140 mm. Then what is the height? So height is directly given here, that is 37 mm. So here we have to consider the height, that is 37 mm, which is equal to 148 mm. Now what is the width? So width is also given directly, that is 29 mm. So we have to consider here the width 29 mm is equal to 116 mm. So these are the dimensions. Now how to plot this orthographic projection? So for that we have to take one horizontal line, we will consider it as a x-axis, and one vertical line, that will be y-axis. Now there should be some space in between the front view, top view and side view. So we have to keep some distance on both sides of this x and y axis. So you can take here the distance 1 cm or 2 cm. So this distance should be constant. So now we will take here the 2 cm distance above and below of this x axis and on both sides of the y axis, and then draw the parallel line passing through it. Now we will plot the front view, top view and side view. So first we will decide the outline. So our front view is on the right hand side of the given object. So in this orthographic projection we have to plot this front view on the left hand side. So what is this right hand side and left hand side? So because of this y axis there are two sides, that these two quadrants are on the right hand side and these two quadrants are on the left hand side. So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So because of y axis there are two sides, these two are right hand side and these two are left hand side. So now we will plot here the front view on this left hand side quadrant. So I will write here as a front view. So if we observe this object from the front or in the direction of x, what we can clearly see? We can clearly see what is the total length and what is the total height. So here the length is 160 mm and height is 148 mm. So we have to consider the length on the horizontal line. So we have to take here 160 mm, and the height we have to consider here, that is on vertical line, 148 mm, and we have to complete this block. Now we will move for the top view. So when we observe this object from the top, which lengths we can clearly see? We can clearly see what is the total width and what is the total length. Now this top view is getting vertically aligned with the front view. So we have to project the lines from the front view to the top view in vertically downward direction. So here is the edge, so we have to project it from the front view to the top view. So this length, that is the total length, is getting aligned from the front view to the top view. Now what is the width? So width is 29 mm, so we will take 116 mm. So we have to take here 116 mm and draw this horizontal line, and then here and passing through this point we will draw here the horizontal line and here is the vertical line. So this outline is getting completed. Now we will move for the side view. So when we observe this object from this side, then which lens we can clearly see? We can clearly see what is the total width and what is the total height. So this side view is getting horizontally aligned with the front view. So we have to draw here the horizontal line. So this height is getting aligned. Now we have to plot here the width. So we can project this width from this top view. So this will be our top view. So how to project? So in this fourth quadrant, we have to take line which will split it into two equal parts. So here, angle in between this x-axis and this line is 45 degree. So if we draw this line, then we have to take the projection of this base line or this line up to this inclined line, and then at the point of intersection we have to draw the vertical line that will project towards the side view. So at the point of intersection, that is horizontal line from the front view and this vertical line from the top view will intersect this, and here we have to complete the block, and this will be the outline of the side view. So in this way, all the four, that is the outlines, are getting completed for the front view, top view and side view. Now front view is considered as the principal view, so we will draw the first the front view. So if we observe this diagram, what is the total length? Total length is 40 millimeter, and now there is the semicircular structure. So we have to concentrate on that semicircular structure. So whenever there is the circular or semicircular structure, we have to first select the center. So now where is the center here? So its center is on the middle point. So we will select here the middle point for this total length. So here is the total length. So we have taken here as a 160 millimeter, that is 16 centimeter. So here at the point of 8 centimeter, we have to draw here one vertical line, and that will be passed through this middle point. Now this line will be passed through the center of the semicircle. So remember that we have to draw this in the form of dash and dot. So we can extend this from the front view to the top view also, because these are the lines passing through the center. So we can project this. Now from this line, we have to now how to find out the center. So for that, we have to find out what is the horizontal line passing through the center. So again observe this line. Now for the base semicircle, the horizontal line is at the height of 7 millimeter. So from the base here, the height we have to take as a 7 millimeter. So we have to take 7 multiplied by 4, that is 28 millimeter. So at the 28 millimeter, we have to mark here one point, and from that point we will draw the horizontal line in the form of dash and dot. For the inside semicircle, the diameter is given, that is 7 millimeter. That means radius is equal to 3.5 millimeter. So we have to take 4 times larger. That means multiplied by 4. So we have to take here R is equal to 14 millimeter. And we have to complete this inside semicircle. Then for the outside semicircle, R is equal to 7 millimeter. That is given. So we have to take R is equal to 7 multiplied by 4, that is 28 millimeter. So by taking this center, we will complete this outer semicircle also. Now we will move to the next semicircle. So at the top, again there is the 10 millimeter distance. So from the baseline, there is total 10 plus 7, that is 17 millimeter distance. So we will take here from this line, that is horizontal line, the total distance is 10 millimeter. So we will take here as a 40 millimeter distance and mark here one point. Now our horizontal line passing through center will pass through this point. So we will draw here one horizontal line. So this line will be in the form of dash and dot. So this vertical line and this horizontal line intersect at this point. So this point will be our center of the circle. So again we have to take radius for the inside semicircle, that is 14 millimeter, and we will complete this inside semicircle. And what is the radius of the outer semicircle? That means it is given 7. So our orthographic projection we will take here as a 28 millimeter, and we will complete here this whole semicircle. Now if we observe, these inside semicircles are getting attached with the vertical line. So we will draw the vertical lines. Now we have to complete the construction line. So what is the construction line? So for this construction line, for this outer semicircle, what is the height given? That is 7 plus 5. So this is the total height is 7, and then we have to add 5 millimeter. That means here we have to add the 5 multiplied by 4, that is 20 millimeter. So we will add here the 20 millimeter. So up to this point there is the height. So now we will complete here this whole structure. So I will draw one horizontal line passing through. Now we will draw here the projection line now, and then we will complete the construction. So for the projection line we have to use the 2H lead pencil, because this projection line should be faint. And for the construction line we have to use the H lead pencil. So now for the construction, I will extend this outer semicircle up to this projection line, and then we'll complete this horizontal construction. So in the same way that is given in the three dimensional object, we have to complete this construction. Now here the width is also given. So this width is 5 millimeter. So again we have to select here 5 multiplied by 4, that is 20 millimeter distance on both the sides. So on this both the sides there is the width of 20 millimeter. So we will complete here this width. And it will be attached from this horizontal axis that is passing through the center, and it will complete at the outer point of this semicircle. So in the same way we have to complete it. So if we observe this construction is looking same as given in the three dimensional object. So here the width is also maintained, height is also getting maintained. Now we will move at the top. So at the top there is one rib that is shown. So for this rib, the rib width is 5 millimeter. So we will take here 5 multiplied by 4, that is total width is 20 millimeter. So we have to maintain, or we have to draw here the rib. So what is the starting point and end point of this rib? So from the front view, starting point is this top outline and end point is on this outer semicircle. So on both sides we will take here, that is 10 millimeter distance, and we will draw one vertical line passing through it, because this line passing from the center point of the semicircular structure is also the middle point of this rib. So this rib is getting completed. So now if we observe here this structure, the back construction is also there. So we can see this back construction. So we will draw here with the help of the construction line, because on the back side of this construction there is also one block. So we will complete this. Here the front view is getting completed. Now we will move for the top view. So before that we have to project all the lines. That is here, whenever is the construction completed, we have to project the lines from that construction from front view to the top view in vertically downward direction. In the same way we have to project all the lines from front view to the side view in the horizontal direction. Now we will move for the top. So when we observe this structure from the top, we can see what is the total length and what is the total width. So for the construction we will move for the width. So along the width, what is the construction here? So there, if we observe this top view along the width, we can see what is the gap in between that construction, as well as we can see what is the slope. So now we will complete this construction along the width. So if we observe what is the outline, so here outline is given, that is 5 millimeter. So we will take here from this line, that is 5 multiplied by 4, that is 20 millimeter. So we have to mark here the point, that is 20 millimeter. So here will be the outline for that construction. So this will be the construction line. Now we will complete here. The width for, or the length for this construction is given, that is here is the 5 millimeter. So we have to take here as 20 millimeter. So here is also the length is 5 millimeter. So here is projection line. So we have to extend this line up to projection line. So inside there some gap is there. So what is the width of this gap? So this gap width is 3 millimeter. So we have to take here the point, that is for 12 millimeter, that is 3 multiplied by 4, and we will complete this structure. So here is the same structure along the width we can see. Now what we can see here, we can see what is the rib of that slope. So rib of that slope, that is given 5 millimeter, means what? We have to take the 10 millimeter distance, because what is the total width? 5 into 4, that is 20 millimeter. So we will take here 10 millimeter on both the sides, and we will select here one point, and we will complete this rib. So what is the starting point? So for this structure outline, here is the starting point, and at this base point there is the end point. So we will complete the rib. So this is the rib that is getting completed. Now we cannot see the semicircle structure, and we cannot see what is the gap which we can see from the front view, but it exists. So on the top view, first we will complete what is the outline. So here whole structure is there. So we will complete with the help of the construction line, that means the with the help of the dark line. Now remember that there is inside semicircle structure. So this inside semicircle structure exists for this whole width. Instead, here is the gap of 3 millimeters. So we cannot consider this gap. So this inside semicircle structure exists for this whole width, but we cannot see from the top. So how we can show this? So we have to show this with the help of dash. So here is the line for the inside semicircle. So we will project this. So here is the projection. So for this projection, we will complete this projection with the help of the line with dash. So in the same way, here also the projection. So in this way we have to show this inside semicircle. Now in the same way, this gap is also exist, but we cannot see from the top. So we have to show this gap. So here is the projection of this gap. So this gap exists along the whole width. So here for this whole width, we have to show this in the form of dash. Now when we observe from this top view, here is the gap, but this gap we cannot see from the front view. So from the front view, if we observe, this gap will not exist, but this gap exists for whole height. So this is the height. So we have to show. So again we will project the projection line for this gap. So here is the projection line. So we have to show this. So how to show this? So along this projection line, we will draw here the line with dash. So this is the projection for this gap. Now this gap is there, that exists for whole height of this construction. So up to the baseline, we have to draw this gap. So in this way, this top view is also getting completed. Now we will move for this side view. So what we can see from this side? So from this side we can see what is the total width of this construction. So here we have taken the total width, that is 5 millimeter. So we can see it clearly, 5 millimeter distance. So we will take here the 5 millimeter distance, or simply we can project this line. So it is easy for us to project all the lines from this top view to the side view. So how to project? So it is easy to take the horizontal lines in this way and then draw here the vertical lines. Now we can show here what is the construction. So we can see the outline. So outline is for this 5 millimeter, that means we will select here the 20 millimeter gap. Now this outline is up to height, so this height up to 7 plus 5, that is 12. So here is this total height, that is that I have projected. So here up to this point there is the construction. So here this line will be at 7 and this 5, 7 plus 5. So here up to this point this construction is there, and then we will draw here the outline. So if we observe, this outline can be same, that can be seen from the side view. Then what we can see here, we can also see what is the slope. So here there is the projection of the slope is given, that is at the outer semicircle. So here is the start point at this corner and end point is at the outer diameter of this circle. So here semicircle exists at this point. So we have to draw here the slope. So we will draw the slope here. From the side view we can see clearly what is the edge of that semicircular construction. So we can see this semicircular construction as a straight line. So we have to complete here with the help of the construction line. Now if we observe, here is the gap which we can see from the top view, but it exists but we cannot see from the side view. So we have to project this gap. So this is the line of projection, and we have to take here the line with the help of this dash line. So this gap for whole height, so for this whole height, that is equal to 37 millimeter, we have to take this line in the form of dash. In the same way there is the inside semicircular structure that we can see from the front. So it exists for the whole width but we cannot see from the side view. So again we have to take the projection for this inside semicircles, and we have to take in the form of dash for this whole width, that is for 29 millimeter. So in this way this front view, top view and side view is getting completed. Now we will move for the dimension. So here whatever is the dimension that is given in the object, we have to keep complete it maximum. So here the dimensions we have to show this. Here is the width of this rib, that is 5 millimeter, then the radius of this outer semicircle R7. So we have to show this. Maximum dimensions should be given to the front view and then the remaining for the top view, and the minimum dimension should be given to the side view. So this is the orthographic projection for the given object.